Hello everyone, I'm going to talk about what's new in Satellite 6.11. Satellite 6.11 became generally available in June of 2022. 6.11 builds on top of the backend work implemented in Satellite 6.10, taking advantage of the technical updates to improve the experience of managing Red Hat Enterprise Linux hosts. There are three themes to this release. The first is user interface updates. We're continually investing time and effort into making Satellite easier to use. In this version, we've made a big push to update Satellite 6.11 to match the look and feel of other products in the Red Hat portfolio, which we think will optimize the user experience. This version of Satellite is the first to include Red Hat Enterprise Linux 9 support. And finally, we have simplified the operation of management tasks in Satellite. Various features in Satellite have had the number of operational steps reduced or automated to improve the overall user experience to reduce the overhead of managing a Red Hat Enterprise Linux landscape. As mentioned, Satellite 6.11 will support Red Hat Enterprise Linux 9 hosts. There's nothing to be done, just synchronize RHEL 9 content and register RHEL 9 hosts with your Satellite 6.11 server. We're continuously looking for ways to simplify the operation of Satellite, and in 6.11, there are significant improvements. Content publication workflow requires fewer menu changes. Ansible workflows have been streamlined. As well, we've enhanced the remote execution user experience. We've included a new cloud connector or method of configuring the Satellite server to communicate with console.redhat.com to provide information about hosts for analysis by Red Hat Insights. Here's the new content view publication workflow. As you can see, we've improved the information available in the content view menu, and now content view promotion is bundled into the publishing workflow. The intention of these changes is to make content available with less confusion. There is a new menu for displaying host information. This feature is in tech preview and must be enabled manually. Here's the new view for finding packages installed on a particular host. Here's the repository sets view. This helps you easily determine which repos are available to a host. We've added some help to get your Satellite server operating system upgraded from RHEL 7 to RHEL 8. Satellite 6.11 will support both RHEL 7 and RHEL 8. This will give users greater flexibility in upgrading from the RHEL 7 operating system to RHEL 8. We'll have three upgrade paths. First, there is the new deployment path. Then there is also the backup restore path, also known as cloning. And the final and preferred method is with leap, which is an in-place upgrade operation. So as mentioned, there are three host upgrade paths. The new deployment path is suitable for customers that have already captured their Satellite configurations in code, such as an Ansible playbook. In the backup restore path, this is similar to the new deployment path, but includes the extra step of backing up and restoring content to the new Satellite server. This process can take a long time if your Satellite server stores a lot of content. The leap approach is the recommended in-place method for upgrading Satellite. Now I'll discuss Satellite synchronization with ISS Network Sync. A little background to define the terms or words being used here. Inter-satellite sync is about enabling content synchronization between Satellite servers. There are a couple reasons for it. Security concerns are probably the most prominent. Many organizations do not like having infrastructure connected directly to the internet. ISS Network Sync facilitates a network topology where content is synchronized to a primary Satellite server before the secondary Satellite servers synchronize from it. The connections between all servers are over HTTPS, so you are guaranteed the security of TLS encryption. The function of ISS Network Sync is pretty simple. You just configure your subordinate Satellite servers to use another Satellite as a content delivery network provider. Here's a diagram of how this works. Data is synchronized directly to the primary Satellite server, which stores the content that you need. The secondary Satellite servers in VLAN A and B in this diagram then synchronize their content with the primary Satellite server. Some of you may already know that ISS was available in previous versions of Satellite, and you are correct. However, ISS Network Sync is different in function because it still requires network connectivity. We're now referring to the other ISS sync as ISS export sync because content is exported to the file system before it is transferred to a secondary satellite server. Network sync and export sync use cases are different. We expect that export sync would be used for situations where content must be physically transferred to a satellite server because the network is just not fast enough or reliable enough, or a physical air gap is required. Network sync and export sync are both available in Satellite 6.11. We've simplified Convert2rhel on satellite. Satellite 6.10 introduced the ability to bulk convert CentOS hosts and Oracle hosts to RHEL. In the next satellite, that is Satellite 6.11, we're building on top of that functionality by automating and simplifying the process to configure satellite to perform these tasks. First, there is a new Ansible role for the satellite server, which will perform preparation tasks on the server. Second, there's now an Ansible playbook for the hosts that will prepare the hosts and perform the conversion. These two new features will reduce the overhead of performing bulk Convert2rhel operations. There are way more steps with Satellite 6.10. Here's a rough outline of how it works in 6.11. First, you set the role variables. These include things like adding a new manifest to add subscriptions. Second, you assign the role to the satellite server and run it. This adds the required content like the Convert2rhel repository. Third, you register the desired hosts if you have not already done so. And finally, you run the Convert2rhel playbook against the hosts. We'd like to clarify our integration with Puppet. We are not removing Puppet functionality from satellite. In satellite, Puppet functionality will be provided as a plugin, ensuring that upgrades from 6.10, where Puppet is used, will inherit Puppet functionality. New installations will require that Puppet functionality be enabled as an extra configuration step. Thank you.